Good morning, everyone. Coming to you today to talk to you about the listening portion of our math test. We are going to include a listening portion on our math test for the next 3, 4, 5 weeks. Kind of depends on how well our students are doing. The most important thing on the listening portion of a math test is for students to listen to the question. Teachers will only read the listening part of the math test each question 2 times. On your child's paper, they'll have answer choices and they'll need to mark the answer for the correct choice. I'll give each student a scrap sheet of paper to use to help them solve each of the listening questions. First tip I give kiddos about the scrap paper is to draw a big tic-tac-toe symbol on it. This helps them organize their questions. That way they don't answer one question using the whole front of the sheet of paper and then not have any more room. So students will mark inside one box to answer each question. The second tip and the most important tip on a listening test is to write down every number that you hear. When your teacher reads the question the first time, write down the numbers you hear. When she reads it the second time, figure out what to do with those numbers. So let's do a couple for practice. Number one, there were 12 erasers in a basket. The students used 4 of them. How many erasers were left in the basket? Again, there were 12 erasers in the basket. The students used 4 of them. How many erasers were left in the basket? If kiddos are using erasers, then I know they're subtracting, so I'm going to subtract these 2 numbers. So 12 minus 4 equals 8. So I know to mark 8 on my answer page. Look on this test paper for number 1. Our answer choices are 6, 8, 11, and N. N stands for not here. So if I had added and gotten an answer that was not an answer choice, then I could choose N for not here. Okay, let's move on to number 2. Number 2, James saw 8 bluebirds sitting in a tree. He saw 9 robins in the same tree. How many birds did James see? Again, James saw 8 bluebirds sitting in a tree. He saw 9 robins in the same tree. How many birds did James see? Well, he saw 2 different kinds of birds, and the question asks me how many did he see, so I think I'm going to add these 2 numbers. 8 plus 9 equals 17, so I'm going to mark 17 on my answer page. All right, number 3. Which is the correct way to write 567? 567. Again, which is the correct way to write 567? So I'm going to look over here at my answer choices. I see 500, I know it's not this one because that says 50. 560, so I'm looking for 62nd in the second part. There it is, there's 60. 567, so I'm looking for 7 in the back. So I think this is my correct answer, 500 plus 60 plus 7. All right, let's try another one. Number 4, what is 10 more than 75. Again, what is 10 more than 75? More tells me I should add. So 75 plus 10 is 85. So I'm going to mark 85 on my answer sheet. One more. Number 5. Sam had 8 pieces of candy in a jar. His brother gave him 7 more pieces of candy. How many pieces of candy does Sam have in his jar now? Again, Sam had 8 pieces of candy in a jar. His brother gave him 7 more pieces of candy. How many pieces of candy does Sam have now? So since he got more, I'm going to add. So 8 plus 7 equals 15. I'm going to mark 15. 15's not here. So I'm going to choose N for not here. I hope that seeing how our listening test will go will help you and your kiddos get prepared. Remember, listening is such an important skill that we need all students to have, and it will benefit them in every subject area and later on in life. Thanks for listening today.